Today we're going to talk about different soil mixes, and when looking at a soil mix label, what can you interpret from a soil mix label about that particular mix? And from that, how do we know, is this particular mix going to serve my purposes if I'm purchasing some sort of bagged or pre-blended mix? What are the necessary characteristics? What are the things you're looking for in a soil mix for propagation? We are looking for drainage, aeration, moisture retention. Those are all critical. We also would like to have a pathogen-free environment. And then we may or may not, depending on our purposes, want to be provisioning for fertility in a mix as well. So today we're going to take a look at 7 different mixes that are available to us locally here in the Santa Cruz area. Not as an endorsement of any one mix over another, but just to compare what's in the ingredients and what could I expect or anticipate from this mix were I to choose to use it. Ultimately, if you're investigating, thinking about using a particular mix, I would actually recommend that you seek out samples or buy bags of several different things that you think will serve your purposes, and then do a side-by-side trial or grow out, where you take representative species of what you would typically be growing and then grow them side by side in the different mixes, and then be assessing rate of germination, percentage of germination, and then what does canopy and root development look like over time, and then even how long does my seedling hold up and still look good even after it's reached maturity? Do they hang on for a decent period of time so that if you don't have optimal ability to get your transplants in the ground, that maybe the mix will serve its purpose of holding those plants in good condition a little bit longer? So let's go through some of these different mixes here. This first mix here is one from a local soil producer called Sunland Garden Projects, or Berger, is a Canadian company. And it's really a peat moss based mix. Peat moss, we know, is going to provide us drainage and aeration and moisture retention all together. It's also got quote unquote composted forest products in it, which basically means in our area most likely redwood and fir bark and other sort of refuse from the lumber mills that is then composted and used in soil mixes. It's got some perlite, you can see that, the kind of the white elements in here. The perlite is going to provide us drainage and aeration, a little bit of moisture retention. That composted forest product is going to give us drainage, aeration, retention to an extent, and then maybe over the long term a very, very small amount of nutrients, but most likely it's more of a structural element than a nutrient element. That said, this particular mix has a bunch of different fertilizer blended into it. Now, this is not something you're going to readily be able to see in looking at the mix, but something in reading a label you should be able to get a sense of who's there and what it might provide for me. So it's got feather meal. This mix has feather meal, blood meal, meat and bone meal, sulfate of potash, dolomite, and then it's also got a wetting agent. So what do each of those things provide? Feather meal and blood meal are principally about nitrogen and relatively quickly available nitrogen that's going to be present in the short life cycle that your annual seedlings are likely to be in a container. The meat and bone meal, also nitrogen source, and then potassium source as well. The sulfate of potash is going to provide that too. And then we should also get some phosphorus out of this as well. And then finally, the last two components, the dolomite is to adjust for pH. All of these peat or cocoa peat based mixes, they're going to tend to be very acidic. And for some plants, that would be fine, but most of your annual vegetable and flower crops are going to want a more near neutral mix. So in almost all cases, you're going to find bag mixes like this have some sort of dolomitic lime or calcitic lime blended into them to help balance pH. The wetting agent is simply there because the peat moss in particular, if it dries out, tends to be very hydrophobic. It resists absorbing moisture for a period of time before actually taking up moisture and holding moisture quite well. So the wetting agent helps to facilitate that process. So what do I think about this mix? Well, based on the ingredients, I think we should have all of the sort of key structural properties of a mix well accounted for, and then fertility is present. It's also a fairly fine mix, not any real large particle size and chunky size, so this certainly, I would anticipate this being a really good seed starting and seedling growing mix with fertility being provided for already in the mix. Moving over to this one here, this is one called ProMix PG Organic Plug-in Germination Mix. So right there from the name of the title, I can make some assumptions that it's probably designed to grow young seedlings. This one is almost exclusively peat moss, Canadian sphagnum peat moss, though it also has some coir or cocoa peat in it as well, which, as we know, might be a slightly more sustainable ingredient, serving a lot of the same purpose that the coir provides, or excuse me, that the peat moss provides, drainage, aeration, moisture retention. This mix, it's a little bit harder to see, but there's also some fine vermiculite in it as well. It's just the slight little gold flecks that are in there, and that's gonna give us some moisture retention, some drainage and retention, drainage and aeration as well. This one has both dolomitic and calcitic lime in it to adjust pH, and then it also has a organic wetting agent. We don't know what that actually is, because it's not listed on the label, but because these are all certified organic approved mixes, we can assume, even if we don't know exactly what it is, that it is something that we would be able to register and put on our certification list of inputs or materials that we're using. So what do I think about this mix? I think that this mix is going to have great drainage and aeration. Seeds should germinate fast and grow quickly. However, there's no fertility in this mix. So I'm going to have to think about either transplanting my seedlings really, really early, quickly, or I'm going to need to think of one of two ways of providing for fertility. I might actually blend feather meal, blood meal, some other nitrogen source, and thinking about phosphorus and potassium, I might actually go ahead and blend that in myself. Or once the seedlings are up and developing, a week, 10 days after germination, I might think about coming in with a overhead soil drench and or foliar liquid application, using something like a fish-based product and maybe a kelp product blended together in the water as I'm watering, so that I'm actually providing nutrients in the soil solution or in the liquid that the plants are having access to. This next one, the Sun Grow Propagation Mix number 5, again from the title I can assume that this is a good seed starting mix. The ingredients are a little bit different, but all of the properties and kind of characteristics are actually very, very similar to this one. This one is peat moss. It's about 85% peat moss. There's a fine grade perlite, so there's not going to be big chunky perlite that might obstruct the development of your seedlings, although perlite is so light that that's typically not going to be the case. It has dolomitic limestone for the adjustment of pH. And then this particular brand, Sun Grow Horticulture, they, in many of their mixes, they blend in something at 0.0001%, but a silicon dioxide that they claim that it actually helps plants resist against wilting. And that's one of the things, one of the ingredients in this mix, the smallest ingredients in this mix. Here again, no fertility, so I'm going to have to think about how do I provision for fertility over time, especially for any plants that are going to be in a container for a longer period of time. But except for that, I would anticipate really, really good growth and development in this mix based on its structure and ingredients. This one is another mix called Black Gold Seedling Mix. Again, I would expect that I'm going to have good seedling development. This one is about 80% peat moss. It's also got perlite. You can see there's actually quite a bit more perlite in this mix compared to this one here. And then here they actually tell us what their wetting agent is. Their wetting agent is yucca extract, which is something that you might also have used, say if you're doing foliar applications of both pesticides and fertility agents. That wetting extract, or the wetting agent in this case, also can serve to help break the surface tension on leaves and allow whatever you're applying to bind or hold better on the surface so that the plants are able to uptake that material. So here again, I'm going to expect good performance, but I don't have any fertility, so I'm going to have to think about how do I provision for fertility in this black gold mix. Moving over in this direction, these next three are not specifically for seedlings, but they might or might not perform well for you, and this is where I would do a good trial if this was something you had available, it was reasonably affordable, and you thought, huh, maybe I should try this out. So this is from a company called G&B Organics, and they just call it their, they call it their potting soil. Taking a first look at it, I can see a couple of things. I see some of the original parent material. I see some not fully decomposed material in it. But it's also really nice and coarse and light and open. So probably structurally it's going to be good. But my question would be, how are seedlings going to perform in this? And as I mentioned earlier, how are we going to really know that? Is partly by reading the label, but ultimately by performing a side-by-side grow out and really evaluating what's happening. So this one has recycled, quote unquote, recycled forest products, most likely redwood and fir that are partly partly composted. It's got chicken manure in actually two different forms, both composted chicken manure and dehydrated chicken manure. So that is going to give us a little bit of moisture retention, but it's mostly about being a fairly high nitrogen readily available resource for our seedlings. So that should help with growth and development. It's also got bark fines, so that is screened bark, and that the finer material is going to really help hold water but not obstruct growth and development because of its smaller particle size. There's feather meal, so that's another fertility source, principally about nitrogen. Rice hulls are going to give us drainage and aeration and moisture retention. Thing I like about rice hulls is that it's a byproduct of an existing industry, and so it's in a way is a recycled material rather than a primary sourced ingredient to help make this mix come together. And then there's bat guano. Depending, it doesn't list exactly what bat guano, but it could be, and most likely it's more of a nitrogen source, but sometimes bat guanos could also be a good source of phosphorus or potassium as well. There's perlite for drainage, you can see a little bit of that in there. There's peat moss, there's alfalfa meal. Alfalfa meal is another one that's a good nitrogen resource. Oyster shell and dolomitic limestone, that's going to provide us some calcium, but is also about that pH adjustment. There's worm casting, so there we get some small level of nutrients, moisture retention, and good hormonal balance or hormonal stimulation for plant development as well. And then finally, there's kelp meal. Kelp meal, if it's finely enough ground, should be available relatively quickly. Tiny bit of nitrogen, usually very little phosphorus, and then some potassium, and then a whole array of trace minerals that can be beneficial for your young seedlings as well. So what do I think about this mix? I think, yeah, this could be a good seed starting mix, but I'm not sure about it. It looks a little bit coarse, not fully decomposed, and I'd really want to give it a grow out and give it some trialing before I made a big commitment to it. The last couple here, these are also kind of more general container mixes. but maybe have some potential as your seedling mix. This is one called Roots Organic Formula 707, and it was actually designed for the cannabis industry, but it's something that some vegetable growers are using as well. It has peat moss, composted forest products, perlite, cocoa fiber, so it's got the cocoa peat in there to serve some of the same purposes as the peat moss. It's got pumice, which is a relatively lightweight stone that's gonna give us drainage and aeration. Earthworm castings again, feather meal, bat guano, soybean meal, another nitrogen source. Fish bone meal, nitrogen, some little phosphorus and mostly potassium. Green sand, another potassium resource. Volcanic rock dust for trace minerals, kelp meal, and then it also has a beneficial mycorrhizal fungi blended into it. And that can help with plant vitality and nutrient uptake, resistance to disease, and so forth. What do I think of this one? Well, again, I think this one's a little bit coarser. I certainly like the provisioning for fertility. I even wonder, is there an excess of fertility? But I don't know until I grow it out. This, I think, might work better for plants that I'm going to be running for a longer term period, and maybe not as well for my seedlings, but we'll see that when we trial it. You can see here, too, the perlite is much, much bigger and coarser. That's really useful for drainage and aeration, but is maybe a little bit less ideal for seed germination and early development. And then the last one, this is a mix called Vitality Blend Potting Soil. Again, potting soil being in the name makes me think it's not specifically for seed starting, but could serve well. Kind of nice loose open texture. I see a lot of perlite in here. It's going to give me that drainage and aeration. But they're not quite as big and coarse as the perlite over here in the Roots Organic. This one is actually, the first ingredient on this one is cocoa coir or the cocoa peat. So unlike all of these others where, well, actually two others, the Roots Organic and the Pro Mix, where there is some cocoa coir in it, that in this case, the cocoa coir is the primary ingredient providing us drainage, aeration, moisture retention, and just the bulk of the structure of the mix. There is a compost in here. We don't know what that compost material is, but I'm going to assume that we've got low-level nutrients, but a broad array of nutrients, depending on what actually went into it. Sphagnum peat moss again, perlite, worm castings, the pumice stone, peat hummus, which they don't really define exactly what that is, but that to me sounds like a more decomposed, more fully decomposed peat moss that's gonna maybe provide us some nutrients and at the same time some drainage and retention and aeration happening. Glacial rock dust for micronutrients, dolomitic lime for pH adjustment, and then seabird guano as a nutrient resource. Most likely it's a nitrogen seabird guano, but we don't actually know that because they don't list the NPK typically in any of the ingredients that go in or in the final mix. So in conclusion, we have seven different mixes here, all of which have great potential, but we're not going to know what they will best do for us until we do a grow out and some side-by-side trialing. But to recap, these four mixes here were all designed as seed starting mixes. And structurally and ingredients wise, I have great confidence that our seedlings would perform very well in all of them. However, these three do not have any fertility, so we're going to have to think about provisioning for fertility. Whereas in this first one, there's ample fertility blended in and should cover our needs for the life cycle of the seedlings. These three over here all have fertility blended in them, but they're not specifically seed starting mixes. These are more what would be referred to as potting mixes, and they may work well for us, but I would want to trial them and see. And the main concern or question mark that I have is just there's a little bit bigger, chunkier, more coarse material, a little bit less broken down, and sometimes that material that is actively decomposing in your growing environment can be a little bit of an inhibitor to development for faster growing young seedlings. So we would try them out and see what we think, because otherwise they look good. I like the ingredients list, and I want to see how they're going to perform.